Hit record. All right, you guys, how are you doing? Thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah,
absolutely. So the pandemic clearly inspired many works of art in these past 2 years. Why did you decide to take a comedic approach in the long isolation?
Well, you know, we had been watching a lot of, you know, plays and things that people have written online, and they all dealt with the tragedy, of course, of the pandemic and the horrible things. And we also were kind of getting, I don't want to say getting tired, but with the news, between the news and everything we were watching, we were like, we want to laugh. We just want to try to get our minds off of it for a while. So we decided to write this comedy, dealing with being isolated, but kind of just dealing with thematically, which is why it's the long isolation.
And also we have like, it's the group that's in it, it's part of an improvisational workshop we're in. And they're all comedic actors. So of course we're going to utilize them with their, you know, to the best of their ability. So we fashioned it for them.
Right. And I mean, as far as quarantine projects go, this is by far the most creative that I've seen. How did you figure out how to do that much with Zoom?
That was during, like, there weren't, you know, we had to stay home. Everyone had to be isolated. There was no vaccine yet. So we were working with some young actors and the theater department at UCSB, and we were doing some of our short plays with them. And we noticed that they were using virtual backgrounds for some things and doing green screen. And they were doing it in some creative ways where there was like two people in the same space, but in reality, they weren't in the same space. So we got in touch with some of the young women who are amazingly talented to be our technical directors on the project. And then we thought about, our inspiration was to do a Zoom noir because we were thinking about what could we do with our group, and also inspired by the film noir, Lady in the Lake, which is in black and white, and also it's one person on the screen at all times. So I thought that would be, we thought that would be a great way to kind of tell our narrative by one character at a time. And it's kind of like a whodunit, you know, it's a mystery. So you always have the different characters, which is like the Lothario, the femme fatale, you know, everyone is
involved. Right, and there was always the detective who had a grudge against the private eye. And
yeah.
I mean, I want to hear a little bit more about that process of creating the film about isolation while actually in isolation, because you guys were creating a film without being in the same room together, right?
Yeah. Yes. So it would be general, it would be us directing via Zoom with our actors, and they would use the camera on their computer. And then Allison, who was McSwain, who was our editor, she was on Zoom and she would be recording all of the takes.
And so what we did, we sent green screens to all of our actors, and we sent, if they didn't have lights, we sent lights. Some of them had their own mics, but we usually just used the mic from the computer, and we sent fedoras, costume pieces, props that we needed. We actually had prop guns here for other theater shows we've done, so we would have to
drop them off at the front door, and sometimes, like, somebody's husband or wife would come home and go, "What's this bag with a gun in it?" You know? And then all of the stuff was put on Dropbox, and then we would look at all of the clips from that and make our picks.
And so we decided to do, which was great to do it in black and white, because Zoom has that feature to do black and white, though we didn't use that. We actually had Allison make everyone black and white, but it kind of, we didn't have to deal with color correction. You know, if everything's black and white, you can kind of hold the characters together in a space. And we used virtual, not virtual backgrounds, but visuals from the LA Public Library that are, you know, retro or from the
40s.
They have, yes,
archive of all of these old photographs that you can access through your computer.
So that was like our green screen. That's what she used for our green screen. And we would adjust them. We would kind of have to sometimes blur the background out because it was too sharp, and our Zoom characters tend to be a little fuzzy sometimes because of what Zoom is. Zoom is very finicky, right? We all know that things blur, and we just kind of had to embrace all that, you know, just like it's an old film, right? Of course.
I mean, did this entire production change your idea of what filmmaking can be? Because it seems like it made it so easy that, like, you no longer need a camera guy. You no longer need, like, so many positions. You can literally just have your computer be like 10 jobs.
Yeah, yeah, I think so.
Doing it this way, of course, if you want to, it gets more involved if you're doing it, you know, different angles and so forth and so on. And then there are people who, there are ways also where people would just shoot at home with their camera and then you direct them, but you'd have to then look at what they the way they
yeah.
shot it, as opposed to while we're doing it, we can see what's going on, you know, while you're getting the video feedback while you're shooting.
But it did help, yeah, to your point, it did help us say, okay, we have this limitation, we're stuck at home, we're going to deal with just this square, black and white, film, like, what can we do? And you can actually do a lot. It's pretty amazing when you have those restrictions, you know.
Pretty impressive. Did the making of the film ultimately keep you guys sane during your isolation?
Oh, absolutely.
I think that's why we did it.
We did it, yeah. I mean, and it was great because we had contact with all of our friends who were in the workshop, so.
We would laugh a lot.
And they enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was a lot of work, but we laughed a lot, and it was really rewarding to make it.
I love that. Well, congratulations on The Long Isolation. It is such a cool film, and I cannot wait for people at Santa Fe Film Fest to see it.
Okay, great. Thank you so much.
Great, thanks.
Nice but talking to you.
And also, okay. I'm sending prayers to your puppy. I hope.
Thank you. I think he's in good hands, but good. Thank you.
Right, good. We'll go run back to him. Thanks.
Okay, I will. Okay, thanks. Bye-bye.
All right, bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye.